Yeah. Weird that this game does not actually have multiple save files compared to the other game, which had four. So here's the other game. I like this option. That's all it does. So, excuse me, I'm pulling out pictures. Okay, so this game is somehow very similar and different than the original. First of all, you can't even open your inventory. You have to buy an item to do that, and you have to shift. You cannot hold down the attack key. You have to keep mashing it until you get an upgrade for that. As you can tell, I'm already gold farming because that's kind of what you need to do already. So this game's a bit different than the other one, and not really in a good way, honestly. I think this game is a lot. Definitely a lot less interesting than the other, because the other game was full on exploration, puzzles, and bosses, and cutscenes, and it felt like an actual game. But this game probably should already start farming for this as soon as I get the ability to hold down my attack. I don't even need the inventory yet. I think no, the fairy does not actually let you hold down the attack. But is she even firing? Oh my god, you have to get another item for that too. Oh my god. Yeah, this game, you definitely do not have a lot of ability. You're so much weaker at the start of this game than in the Doremi game, which is kind of crazy, but you know. And yeah, straight from the beginning, you're already farming gold. Hopefully, I remember to show what the death for Doremi looked like, because I didn't show that in the other Let's Play. I forgot to. I mean, it's just her hat falling, but I feel like I should show it. And I'm probably gonna see it this game. If we don't, I'll show it. I'll have to censor it, because, like I said, her cunning shows in the death animation. Also, the H images in this game do not show up when you pick them up. You have to go in your inventory and click them yourself, which means I probably am not going to need to censor as much this game. Again, if you want to see the rips of them, they're on Sad Panda. You can just go find them. Something else I forgot to mention in the Doremi game, which I don't know if I'm gonna bother showing in post. But if you recall the item in the water Mahodo area, that. The speed up item, there's like three arrows. You can actually go to your inventory and press, like, interact with it, and it will go from like one arrow filled up to two arrows filled up to three arrows filled up. When you press it again, it goes to showing six arrows and filling those up. Which is, I suppose, pretty And basically what that does is it... sorry, I'm falling asleep. I'm tired as hell recording this. And it just speeds you up. So there's actually just a way to make your character faster in the Doremi game, which is kind of cool, I guess. Which definitely would have helped me speedrun it a bit better. Because afterwards I accidentally... In my desire to try and find everything a game, I actually ended up somehow deleting my save data for the Doremi game. But I beat it as fast as I could, which still took like 40 minutes because... I think 40 minutes or 30 minutes, something like that. And the reason why is because the gold card never dropped, which means that I actually had to pay basically double the price of the entire game. I don't know if there's like a trick to make the gold card drop more, because I think every time I've gotten it to drop, in the like three or four times I've beaten that game, it was always in the first room. So I don't actually know. Okay, now I have in my... These, are just like, the items from, the use items, except they're all attacks in this. And they are... You can get infinite use versions, but you have to get individual ones. I don't actually know what this does. This makes you get more money drops, more hints, extra heart. This, I think this gives you health. Knife, well, yeah, gives you one health. This increases your max hearts. These are the things that give you infinite uses of the different things. Probably just gonna buy... I should probably get... How much is this? 100. I'm getting 100 of these. And I have the bigger shots, which is good. And instead of solving, well, I guess you're still technically solving puzzles. Instead of solving puzzles like you do in the Doremi game, you just fight these like bosses also. Sometimes just those randomly drop. I don't know if they drop or if like it'd be in a specific location in the map. I don't know. So pretty sure I got it in the same place last time, but also I was farming here last time, so. I'm probably gonna die, which, you know, I guess I need to show the thing, but you know. This does mean I'm going to lose my money. So I guess I'm gonna go and spend all my stuff. I guess. That purple item, by the way. Oh, now I can hold it. Oh, that's the item. Is that... This is the item that lets you hold it down. Okay. Oh, yeah, you can do this. I don't know exactly what it's used for. So yeah, that was the death. You might need to slow it down, because it is pretty fast. Also, yes, that means that the Purulent computer, you just have that in the corner of the screen at all times. It's funny. What I'm trying to do now is just get some more upgrades, because this game is even more farm oriented than the Doremi game. Like, it feels like most of what you do in this game is just farming, because there's no exploration. You know what, I'll say it when I get there. There's a reason there's an infinite supply of these like little small popcorn guys coming after me. Thank you. So I'm assuming, yeah, the inventory I believe is much smaller as well. I think. I don't know. These ghosts are pretty annoying. And they just spawn infinitely from. You know, I should probably get out of here and buy something, because I think I'm gonna die again if I try going those right now. Maybe. Where was it? I don't know what item I wanted. I don't remember. I think this is the three-way shot, which I actually kind of do want. I mean, I want all of this, but, you know. Yeah, no, that's a huge DPS upgrade. My fairy still isn't shooting. I don't have that yet, but, you know. I mean, hey, I at least when I said this game was pretty always harder than the Doremi one, I suppose it is, considering I am dying more. Also, your last health counts as a piece of health. Like, your last health, like, when you have no arms. So I'll just do something before I die. I do have some other information on the other games, but I'll probably save that for a little bit. Maybe tell more about that later. I don't know. Because I do have some more information on the Aiko and Aku game. I don't have them, but I found a site that does have them for sale. I don't know if they're still for sale. I don't actually know, but it had them on it. If I can't find a download for it, I guess I could theoretically buy them. I don't really know how the buying of these things work, actually, but... Oh, God. I have a lot of money, too. Please don't kill me. Get out of here. What was I gonna buy? Let's see. What'd I get? I think I can hold down. Yeah, hold the fire. I think I yeah, my fairy can shoot now. So yeah. Possibly I could get my whole hands on the other games. I don't know. I might not bother. I don't know. Because this game is definitely not as good as the Doremi one. But... And I have a feeling that this game is just kind of as... Like, the Iconopo game are probably going to be on the level of this one. From the screenshots I have of them. I have pictures of the, like... back of the games. Also, all the games have the same plot. The back of the game box says the exact same thing. It's just Majoruka, Tid, balloon photos everywhere, and you have to find them. Also, I don't think this game, I feel like, has less good H images than the other one, to be honest. Also, this gate right here looks sus AF. But as far as I know, it doesn't actually do anything. And now it feels like I've done all the puzzles here, but actually, as you go in and out of Mahodo, more things spawn. Also, yes, when I go to the corner... Oh, excuse me. You'd think, like, you could go to the other room or something. Nope, this is a single-room game. There is nothing else. It's just that this room chain modifies itself over time, basically. Which, I suppose, is a neat idea, but... I'd say it's not executed super interestingly, because most of the puzzles that are added are just like random like event things that happen. I don't know. I suppose I should probably. I don't know. Should I just. I don't have money. I'll just. You know, I need to get. How much do I need? 1,000. Guess now I just start farming again. Oh, I mean, there's the pumpkin boss. I swear, on my last playthrough, I thought I was missing the pumpkin boss. Like he never spawned, but no, I guess I just killed him and forgot. So I was, like, trying to find this dude forever, because there's actually an item you can get at the very end that costs 9,999 yen, which isn't the cap, by the way. And it's like, I think it says it is a, it mentions the pumpkin boss, I think, on the item. And there's like the hint that corresponds to a hint number, I think 8 or whatever it was, I don't remember, also mentions the pumpkin boss. So like, I was just missing something of the pumpkin boss for like ages, but I guess, let me actually check something. Hold on. I don't even know what I just ate, which pumpkin, but whatever. So that was a pumpkin boss. It's not very that interesting now, is it? Also, notice Hazuki does not have like a firing animation. She's just standing and it's just sitting there. It doesn't put her wand out like Doremi does, which is a shame. I don't want this whole thing to be me just shitting on this game, but I don't like it as much as the other one. Also, I'm watching back the other Let's Play, because I watched the other Let's Play like 4 or 5 times to make sure there's no, like, not a frame of, like, nippage showing. I noticed that that noise I make, does pick up on, like, pretty clearly. So, I'm a little bit self-conscious about it. It is just a weird tick I have. Also, it seems this game actually does take place in the Witch World. So, you know, there's that. Spawns. Oh, it's gone. I don't think it'll ever come back. Oh, here's a new thing. It's this. And I can't do this yet, actually. I need a specific. I think. Wait, can I just walk in? No, I can't. Okay. So in order that you actually need a specific use item, so I guess I can't, I mean, I guess I could keep farming here. That'd be really boring. Basically, you need to use one of the single-use items to kill that. I'm pretty sure. The problem is I don't remember which one it was. Might have been the brown one. I don't know. Or I don't know. It's one of them. I will say the use items in this game are definitely a lot more cute than the Doremi game ones. I think a lot of the ones in the Doremi game, this one shares some of the ones in the Doremi game, but the unique ones it has are honestly a lot better, more integrated in the game. Also, oh my god, this farming is slow. Okay, finally. No, I'm actually gonna get money to drop. I still need the gold one, but I'm not gonna do that right now. Should probably get like 200 so I can buy the, hopefully the one I think that it is that I need to use. Hoping I remember that this is the like, solution to the puzzle. Let's see if this is it. So this whole mechanic thing is a whole mechanic, basically. So every time I press the X button, it cycles through. Well, I only have one to cycle through, but when I use it, I don't remember if this is the right one or not. This is definitely one of the cutest ones, though. Look at that. Yeah, that wasn't it. Oh boy. So this is probably gonna be trial and error. I'm assuming that's even it. I think last time I did, I used a special item, and then I just kind of walked in and just shot it. So I don't know if I need a special item or if I need an or need a specific upgrade. Don't really know. I could try more of them, or I could try buying something. I could try buying. That's for the title screen, I think. It might be this, probably not. Yeah, if it's not this, then it has to be one of these. But I don't remember which one it would be. I don't know what I should do, honestly. I guess just farm? Which, I guess if that's the case, it's pretty boring. I'm just gonna go over here and just. I'm gonna hate walking all the way back. Gate's still sussy AI. Of course, there's nothing else actually over here. It's the only thing to farm is just the little babies. Which, I just realized, those are the same sprites, I think, as the, one of the use items, not use items, one of the item drops you can have in the Doremi game. But I don't think I ever figured out what it is. I think it makes things unstealable from you. Because it's called, like, anti-item or something like that, I don't know. So I don't really have any fun. I don't think I have any fun stories to tell, necessarily. I know there was, when I was really young, my brother was kind of playing a bit rough with me, and, Matt threw my head into an aquarium with fish in it. Not on purpose. Yeah, that was kind of fucked up. I guess. Don't worry, the fish were fine, I'm pretty sure. And, I don't know if I was. Like, as far as I know, I never recovered from it. I don't know. Maybe it would give me brain damage. My brother once dropped, like, also when I was young, around probably around the same time. Like, in the same year, time frame. My brother, like, dropped a sprite can on my big toe, and it's still cracked to this day, I think. Let me check. Oh, it actually isn't anymore. Sweet. Yeah, I really look at my toes that frequently, I guess I kept track of my toes were still cracked or not. Yeah, no, they're good. But I know it was cracked for up until like recently, I think, honestly. Because like last, like when I, like a few years ago, it still was. I'm gonna cut this hole out, this is embarrassing. Another story, I think I might have already, no, I don't think I have. One time, I was walking outside my back porch, and there's like a giant tree back there, at my old house at least, and a squirrel landed in like the hood of my hoodie that was down, and both me and the squirrel were pretty terrified of that. My mom had to like pick it out, like take it out and like let it go. So yeah, years later, I was at my friend's house, and she had, like, a trampoline, and we were, like, playing on the trampoline, I sat down for a second, on the trampoline, and, like, they bounced at such an angle that I sort of, like, hit my head on the metal bits, and, hit so hard that I started, like, got a concussion, like, I started bleeding from my head and started, like, going in and out of consciousness, I had to go to the hospital. Okay, no, there's probably an item I need. And I had to go like the emergency room and all that. It's pretty like on the right, like the right side of my head. It hurt. I guess I'm just gonna buy random ones. I don't think it's this one. I mean, I think it hurt it a little bit, but... Oh, I have extra lives. That's very helpful. That wasn't it. It's not white, not brown. I wonder how long this game's gonna be compared to the other one. I have no idea. Let us try these ones. Pink and silver. I think Invincible, but I still can't hurt it. I mean, it didn't do anything either. Oh boy. Let's see. Pink. Dark blue, light blue. I don't think it'd be the blue ones, but I guess I'll go to the blue ones. Try the blue ones last, I guess. It'd suck if the use items aren't even what you need to use, you just like something else. didn't even hit it. Can I just... It's not working. I'm beginning to wonder, maybe it's something else I need to do. It might not even be a use item. What other items do I even have to get? It might be this thing. I don't know. I might just save to get that, maybe. I don't know. I might just cut or, like, speed up parts of this. I don't know. Because I can't imagine this being fun to watch. You know, I have a compulsive habit of every time, like, in the Doremi Carnival theme, you know the part in the song where I go winks near the start? I think I wink every time I hear it. Almost every time. So, like, these games, I'm winking constantly. Cool tip, when you're, skirting across the ground like this, your character goes up and down a little bit, and that can actually miss some of the coins on the ground. If you hold down, you just grind across the floor, which means your hitbox stays floored, so you can get coins easier. The more you know. Let us see if this works. If not, I need to grind for it anyway, eventually, but, you know. So I'm going to occasionally speed up the grinding segments and try to put in some sort of commentary or something here and there to keep it from being too boring. No, I'm not editing any of it out, so, you know. So you know how much I'm actually grinding. You get it. Just have to hit it a lot. I don't know. There's no hit sound or hit effect when you hit it. So maybe I was. I don't know. But I suppose this puzzle's done. Interesting. Is there nothing out new? Yeah, what the hell? Where's all the new stuff? It already feels like I almost beat the game, but obviously you can tell I have not. Whoops. Got some of that. Look, guys. Look. Box art for the Doremi game. Wow. God, this Let's Play must be so much more boring than the other one. Look, box art for the Hazuki game. The game you're watching right now. Isn't that cool? Wow. And also, here's the back of the box that I'm gonna have to censor, but, you know. But the very, crusty image quality. Very nice. And a screenshot of the exact game you're watching. Isn't that neat? And here's a look at the Ico box art. And here you can see the back of the box art with the Gyaru lady from the Doremi game Sad Panda. You can see the ship. And that first screenshot looks like a creepypasta Ico.exe. And here you can see some screen caps. You can see the cat ship again. And you can see Hachitaro as a, I guess, some sort of quest giver. I don't know. And here's the box art for the Ampu game. And the back of the box art for it. Notice it has a different UI with the little squares in the top right corner. No magnet item. As far as I remember. You will grind for cunning. So, I don't actually know what else to put here. So here's a funny video. Put your glue bottles in the air, Chilf Nation, Chilf Squad forever. I don't know if anything even else happens in this game. For like the rest of any of this. I don't remember. Despite the fact that I just, like, beat it not that long ago. I mean, not that long ago, but, like, I beat it, like, a few hours ago. But, you know, I've forgotten most of it because I've been playing it in sporadic bursts. The only thing I did today was just manage to beat the game by pure luck. Because, one of the items, just, like, if you see me hovering around here, a chest just dropped from here one time. And I don't know if it was, and that was like contained the final item. I don't know if that was this RNG, an RNG drop, or what the hell that was. I have no idea. I may ask why I did that. And that's how I can have infinite uses. And I like the idea of having that, something like that, in a game like this. It helps you grind more efficiently, but it honestly doesn't. Like, does this really make you grind more efficiently? So why does it not even let me use it again? What the hell? Oh, there we go. Like, it doesn't actually help you grind any more efficiently having a full map attack, really. So just kind of like, what's the point? I mean, it is cute, but... I guess all I do now is just grind. Okay, the only thing you do in this game... I'm just gonna buy the pens, fuck it. I will say one thing this game does have with the Doremi games. I like the Doremi games like art a lot too. But I like this art style. Like, it definitely feels like an upgrade in the art, like the background and stuff like that. Probably because they only made one room, but you know. Also, I know at some point you unlock an item that just makes you invincible. Which is just like... Okay. At that point I realized, oh yeah, I must have beat the game. I guess this will have a lot of editing in it. Oh, but not the fun kind, the funny where, but the funny faces over, you know, inappropriate things. But the kind where I just have to speed up and slow down and make cuts and shit all the time. Whoa. Need that many hints for a game like this. In the other game, I don't think you really need really much hints. But you know, they have to make it a little bit simple for the kiddies playing, right? So I'd say the reason why I don't really like this game as much as the other, if it wasn't obvious, is that in the other game, it only feels like a super grindy game when you already know where you're supposed to go, more or less. When if you don't know what you're doing, and you're still like exploring and trying to solve puzzles and stuff, it doesn't feel like you're grinding that much, because you make money on the way to and for, or you know, back and forth while you're, you know, farming. You know, you farm while you move around. Where here, it honestly feels worse if you don't know what you're doing. Because I need to buy an item. You know, oh, I need to buy another item. I need to buy another item. And that's all you do is just buy more items. And, like, there's not really much puzzle solving here. No, it's there. Like, how many of these things were actually puzzles, you know? A lot of it was just... There's a thing here, shoot it until it dies. And they're not like they have complex patterns or something. Not like any of them really that challenging. The only thing that's hard was the tornado thing. So I don't know. that normal? So I guess this means I can show all the items. These items. So it's the one I've already seen. Next one. I love that one. I saw people posting out of stress all the time. I didn't know it even came from this game. I like this one. It's a frog. Bubbles. Same ones from the Doremi game. Very long, early after. Here's the dark pages. Oh, sweet. I just got another Hentai picture. Random drop, I assume. I'm using all the magic, I don't know. It's the pink one, which also is in the dark. I think if you hold it down, she does it longer, I think. Let me go back to the hood and buy some stuff before I die. I don't think I have an extra life. Is actually kind of useful for grinding because it goes off the screen and shoot behind you. Getting to disappear so fast, I don't know, it wouldn't even be that helpful. And then, funny little snowman. And the only thing left to do is to grind some more stuff and get that random drop. I believe after you enter, empty out the shop. New item spawns, and I don't know what the new item does. I'm guessing it just allows the other thing to drop. I don't know. I thought it mentioned something about a pumpkin, or at least the hint that was like that I thought was associated with that picture. Like the missing picture is picture number. Eight, I think that is. Yeah, eight. So I looked at hint number 8 and it mentions a pumpkin boss. I was like, well, what the hell? I completely forgot the pumpkin boss even was a thing because it just happened. And I was so confused. But yeah, I don't know. I don't know where the other the last stage picture is or how you really get it. It might just be a random drop. I don't know. Which if it is, it's pretty lazy, but. I might just cut to the point of something actually happening if I have not already done that at this point. You know, because there's nothing to fucking talk about. There it is. You know what? I think I figured out. It's that hard set, 9,999 yen hard, that makes you invincible. That should be obvious. It replaced the heart items. Yeah, I know. Knowing Japanese would probably have helped me with that, but shut up. Wow, I wonder what track is going to be in the Ico and Ompu game. I wonder what song is going to play throughout the entirety of those games while you run back and forth shooting the same enemies. Yeah, you can tell that in this game, it actually did contain a lot of the, quote-unquote unused sprites in the Doremi game. Most of them. First of all, the sprite sheet for this game didn't contain any unused sprites, except maybe, like, the pumpkin boss. There was actually, another pumpkin in there that I don't think I saw there. It looked like a weird pumpkin tree stump facing to the left. But other than that, I think all the sprites in this game were used. And a couple of, like, the ones in the Doremi game, I think, were used here. Not all of them. Like, the Yaru lady. That actually is in, I think, the Ico or Ompu game, I don't remember. So if I look at, this one. I believe what this says is, yeah, this one says something like, a pumpkin boss or something. Take the pumpkin boss, for example. And it aligns with the eighth one. But I killed the pumpkin boss and it did not tell me anything. So I don't know. I think I might be invincible. Yeah. As if the game was not snooze fest enough. glad I shut off the death already, because that would have been problematic. Especially because you can't make other save files, so... I actually delete my save. Oh god. Glasses here, but I don't know how you get them. Now I have the glasses. Now, one may ask, what are those for? And the answer is, I don't really know. From what I believe this says is, I can't see it, but I can see it or something? Which... I don't really know what that doesn't really help me with much, but I know that shortly after getting that, I did get the final item to drop, and I remember I was using spells around here, but for some reason I can't use spells anymore. Like, the button isn't doing anything, and I'm very curious as to why. Maybe it's bugged? Hold on. Okay, I can use it now. So this is the only way to respawn enemies? The enemies spawn now. What was I doing to make them spawn? Was I doing this? I'm only making that connection because glasses. It was just a random chest that dropped from one of these trees. But it could have just been a random drop. I don't really know. If it's a random drop, this really is gonna suck. Also, why can't these guys respawn? Unless they do now, I don't know. Like, give me something else to do. That's how you can respawn these guys infinitely. It might actually be worth doing that. Just for more money gain. because the ghosts give so the ghosts of Tombstone gives so much money. It actually might be worth it. Just click save and quit over and over or something. So as a potential speedrun strategy if anyone wants to try and anyone ever wanted to try and speedrun this game. Just reset and keep. I have no idea what I need to edit and what I don't. This entire Let's Play is going to be an absolute just fucking travesty of just like cuts and edits everywhere. Shop empty. So what I might do now is stop the recording and start the recording again when I find the random drop item. However, I'm kind of scared that by doing that I might accidentally run into the chest. And that could definitely be scary, because I don't want to accidentally get to the, like, quote-unquote credits and not have it on film. I really hate that. But, you know, I don't want this recording to be an entire hard drive long. Because I don't know when this thing is gonna drop. I have no idea. So honestly, not sure what the best thing to do at this point would be, because that's all I'm missing, and I know it's a random drop. So I mean, I think it has something to do with those trees back there, but I don't actually know. So I guess I'll just stop the recording and pray to God I actually don't collect the chest immediately. So, I found it. What? So I guess I found it twice. So basically, I was tabbed out talking to somebody, and so I just sat here, and it just fell. So it's not a random drop, you just have to AFK at the tree, which I, and these both give the same item. Like a kid show. Or and so that's everything. Nothing else to show, as one could see. And the inventory. I'll go ahead and hover over these manuals to translate them. I'd show the hentai and then crop it for big mega ultra funnies, but sorry, I'm already gonna have to edit this shit a lot, and most of it isn't even that interesting. You can see it on the, like, it's on Sad Panda, who cares? The only thing else now is you can do this again. And CG view, which I'm gonna have to censor all this. Wow. Yep, that sure is, hentai. I can still... She says the artist, I believe. This one's pretty good. At least the chest is flat. This is probably my favorite one, to be honest. I like this one. This is pretty good. Okay, and that is everything. So nothing else to show. I'll go ahead and pick, interact with all these just in case there's anything to interact with. Exit game, get it up from here.